To set up the HYPROP after degassing, you will need the following supplies. Connect the sensor unit to the computer via the USB adapter. This enables you to monitor the pressure increase when screwing in the tensio shafts to prevent damage to the pressure sensors. Disconnect the HYPROP sensor unit from the vacuum refilling station only after the vacuum has been slowly released. Remove the sensor unit refilling attachment by lifting it off from one side. To attach the tensio shafts into the sensor unit, use powder-free gloves to avoid touching them. Remove the tensio shaft carefully without tilting them to avoid losing water from the refilling adapters. After degassing, the shafts should be completely filled with degassed water. Check the meniscus on the shaft end. If needed, use the syringe filled with distilled and degassed water to build up a meniscus. Click on the Show Device icon. If you need to do an offset recalibration, see the manual for instructions. Click on the refilling icon. Follow the wizard. At an angle, lower the tensio shaft to the labeled sensor port. Screw in the tensio shaft. Monitor the tension values on the screen. After about 9 turns, the O-ring in the sensor unit begins to seal, and the pressure increases rapidly. When this happens, screw in the tensio shaft by another quarter of a turn in slow steps, not all at once. Be extremely cautious when you screw in the tensio shafts filled with water. Pressure that can damage the pressure sensor increases abruptly at about 9 turns. This pressure should not exceed 2,000 hectopascals or 200 kilopascals, and in no case 3,000 hectopascals or 300 kilopascals. Fill a silicone cap with distilled water. Place the silicone cap on the tensio shaft to keep it wet. Repeat the previous steps for the second tensio shaft. The next step is to check the HYPROP fill. To check the response speed, keep a syringe filled with deionized water on hand. Remove the silicone cap from the long tensio shaft and dry the ceramic tip with a paper towel. Use a paper towel and fan air over the ceramic. Monitor the pressure display on the screen. The pressure should increase up to the atmospheric air pressure minus 1,000 hectopascals or 100 kilopascals within 15 seconds. If the pressure does not rise to tensions close to atmospheric air pressure, see the manual for troubleshooting. As the pressure has reached the atmospheric air pressure, for example 1,000 hectopascals or 100 kilopascals, wet the ceramic immediately with deionized water. This prevents air entering the tensio shaft. If air enters the shaft, the degassing process must be repeated. Put the silicone cap back on the tensio shaft. Repeat these steps for the short tensio shaft. When done, close the wizard. Remove the excess water from the sensor unit and dry with a towel. Attaching the soil and dust protection, push the protective black O-ring on the tensio shaft until it sits in the groove of the sensor unit. Remove silicone caps from the tensio shaft tips. Put the silicone gasket on the sensor unit. Cover tensio shaft tips again with silicone caps and fill them immediately with deionized water. To assemble the sensor unit and the soil sample, set the auger guide onto the saturated soil sample in the water container on the cutting edge of the sampling ring. The small hole should be above the sample ring weight lettering. This makes finding the right position easier when the sensor unit and the soil sample are assembled. Use the tensio shaft auger to drill the holes. Carefully and slowly drill in and make sure the soil sample is not compacted. Fill the drill holes with water to make sure air won't be pressed into the soil sample during assembly. Carefully place the sensor unit upside down onto the soil sample. Make sure no air gaps are introduced and the soil is not compacted. Turn the whole test assembly right side up. Remove the saturation plate and non-woven cloth. If there is some time between mounting the sample and starting the measurement, it's recommended to keep the wet non-woven cloth on top of the sample to avoid evaporation. Fix the soil sample with the clips. Carefully clean the sample ring and clips and dry them to prevent soil and water outside of the ring impacting the measurement. Let the sample equilibrate to reach a hydrostatic condition before starting the measurement. make sure the lid is closed to avoid evaporation. The soil sample and HYPROP are now ready.